Lung infiltrates refer to substances, such as fluid, cells, or other materials that accumulate within the lung tissues and are visible on a chest X-ray or CT scan. These infiltrates are not normal parts of the lung structure and can be indicative of various medical conditions. This video covers the medical definition and provides a brief overview of this topic. So if you're ready, let's get into it. The presence of infiltrates in the lungs can be a sign of inflammation, infection, or other pathological processes affecting the lung tissue. In the context of lung diseases, the term infiltrates is often used interchangeably with opacities, which appear as white or gray areas on radiographic images. Normally, the lungs appear black on a chest X-ray due to the air content, so any deviation from this appearance suggests an abnormality. Infiltrates can vary in size, shape, and location, and their specific characteristics can help in diagnosing the underlying condition. One common cause of lung infiltrates is pneumonia, an infection that inflames the air sacs in one or both lungs. In pneumonia, the air sacs may fill with fluid or pus, creating the appearance of infiltrates on imaging studies. Another condition associated with lung infiltrates is pulmonary edema, where excess fluid collects in the lung's air sacs due to heart problems, infections, or other causes. This condition also leads to the appearance of infiltrates on chest X-rays or CT scans. In addition to infections and edema, lung infiltrates can also be caused by inflammatory conditions such as sarcoidosis or autoimmune diseases like rheumatoid arthritis and lupus. These diseases can lead to the accumulation of inflammatory cells in the lung tissue, manifesting as infiltrates on imaging. Lung cancer and metastatic cancer from other sites can also present as infiltrates, often requiring further investigation to differentiate them from benign causes. Interstitial lung diseases, a group of disorders characterized by scarring and inflammation of the lung tissue, can also show up as infiltrates. These conditions, which include idiopathic pulmonary fibrosis and hypersensitivity pneumonitis, typically present with a pattern of infiltrates that can be identified on a CT scan. The diagnosis and interpretation of lung infiltrates require careful consideration of the patient's clinical history, symptoms, and the radiographic pattern of the infiltrates. Symptoms accompanying lung infiltrates can vary widely, from cough and fever in cases of infection, to shortness of breath and chest pain in more severe conditions like pulmonary edema or lung cancer. Treatment for lung infiltrates depends on the underlying cause. For instance, bacterial pneumonia is typically treated with antibiotics, while pulmonary edema may require medications to remove excess fluid and treat the underlying heart condition. In severe cases of cancer, treatment may involve surgery, chemotherapy, or radiation therapy. But as previously mentioned, lung infiltrates are radiographic findings indicative of an abnormal presence of substances in the lung tissue. They can be caused by a wide range of conditions, from infections and inflammation to heart disease and cancer. Accurate diagnosis and treatment of the underlying cause are crucial for managing the condition effectively. If you want to support the channel, please like and subscribe. I would greatly appreciate it. And there should be some other helpful videos popping up on your screen right about now that I think you will enjoy. And just a quick reminder, we are not doctors. This video is for informational purposes only. Thank you so much for watching. Have a blessed day, and as always, breathe easy, my friend.